In Unit 1 of this course, you will learn a variety of strategies for answering the question, what makes a quality website? After all, before you can plunge into creating your own sites, it's important to do a bit of planning first, and in this unit, you'll be developing a set of criteria to help guide your creation. Now, we've all experienced websites that we feel are well designed, and those that aren't. But what makes some websites better than others? First off, good quality websites use color effectively. Effective use of color can entail everything from the selection of an appropriate color scheme to making sure that those with color-related visual impairments can still use your site effectively. We'll also discuss browser-safe colors and their diminishing relevance in the current technological landscape. Good quality websites follow web standards so that they work equally well across browsers, platforms, and monitor resolutions. In this unit, you'll learn about the different standards put forth by the World Wide Web Consortium that you'll be following for the rest of this course, for both the form and the content of your site. Good quality websites are accessible to individuals with disabilities.
For example, is the website optimized so that a blind person making use of a screen reader application can easily navigate it?
If a site contains audio or video, does it also offer transcripts or captioning to help make that content accessible to those with hearing difficulties? In this unit, you'll have a chance to view some videos of people with disabilities and the everyday challenges they face in accessing information on the web. And finally, good quality websites are well-structured and well-planned. This unit is designed to get you thinking about your site's organizational framework. When planning the site's structure, you'll need to think about the needs of your particular audience. After all, the design of an entertainment site will differ drastically from that of an online training course or an e-commerce site like this one. After establishing the target audience, it's time to sketch out the actual structure, such as the hierarchy of pages that branch out from the homepage, as well as the site's navigational conventions. Once that's in place, you can implement additional user-friendly elements, such as contact information, a search bar, and a section for the latest news. You'll learn about all these and more by the end of this unit.